Jesus' name. You see, I'm a man of God. See, I'm not just a man of God because I wear designer suits. Even though it's part of it. I'm a man of God because I decree a thing and it comes to pass. Today's healing service. Nobody will live here unhealed. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Pull your neighbor in the neck and shout, yeah. Praise the Lord. You know, let me just give you some testimonies of the people I've healed so that your faith can be boosted. A brother called me last week, said he was not feeling fine. I said, come to my house. He came by, said, kneel down. He knelt down. I prayed for him. The following day, he called me. He said, man of God. I said, yes, testify. He says, I'm in the hospital. I said, what are you doing in the hospital? You're not supposed to be in church to give thanks. He says, sir, when you pray, it's like God works. Shut up your mouth. What do you know about healing? What do you know about healing? Listen to me. Paul will mean to your Bible. Shall lay hands on the sick and the sick shall recover. I laid hands on him, he refused to recover. It's not my fault. Praise God. I am still a man of God. Praise the Lord. So because people have a tendency of saying that because he prayed for me, I did not get healed, he's a fake man of God. If I pray for you, don't get healed, you're a fake Christian. Praise God. You know, because I don't want to bother you to go into the scriptures. I've studied the scriptures, so I'm here for you. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Mark 16, from verse 16 right down to the valley of verse 18. He said, you shall lay hands on the sick. See, God is wise. He has shared the work. Amen. One person lays hands. Then the sick recovers. I lay hands. The sick refuse to recover. It's not my fault. Praise God.